Hello, today in this video tutorial, I'm going to introduce you about booking in TraviYo. Once you share the quotation, you will find that particular lead in opportunity list. So click on leads, navigate to opportunity. This is the entire list of opportunity you can see. You can see this one is the follow up button which we can use to follow up the opportunity list. This is the edit button which is used to edit the lead information. You can see here this red color button is used to get the list of lead that you supposed to follow up today. This one is the reset list button which is used to reset the entire opportunity list. The last one is the filter button which we can use to filter out the opportunity list. Now let me explain you about entire feature of this follow button. So click here. This appearing page is the opportunity follow-up page. You can see here, this is the lead detail section. This one is the suggested quotation section. Whatever the quotation you shared, that will be appear here. Next, this is the manage notes section, manage reminder settings section, and the last one is the timeline section. These sections are dissimilar as the lead follow-up. To get to know more about follow-up page, please refer to our earlier video tutorial for sales automation. You can see here, this is the send quotation button which we can use to send the quotation to customer. Next one is the convert to booking button. If you want to convert your opportunity into booking, then we can use this button. The last one is the cancel lead button. This cancel lead button is used if in any case customer is asked to cancel booking, then you can use this cancel lead option. Now I will tell you how to convert a particular opportunity into booking. First, convert it into booking, we need to do the finalize from here. So click here. Now your quotation is the finalize. So next, click on the convert to booking. So this pop-up message, are you sure to convert this query into booking? Click OK. You can see here, this is the entire booking list. Once you converted a particular opportunity into booking, that will appear in the booking list. So again, this is the follow-up button which is used to follow up the booking list. So click here. This entire page is the booking follow-up page. You can see here, this is the payment schedule button. We can use this button to manage the entire transaction for customer and for supplier. The next one is the convert to complete button. Once your booking is completed, then you can click on this button to make your booking completed. Next is the cancel lead button. Again, if in any case customer is asked to cancel booking, then you can use this cancel lead option. The very last button is the complete calculation button. Before convert to completed, you need to do the calculation. So for complete calculation for your booking, you can click on this button. Now let me explain you about payment schedule button. Click here. You can see this schedule customer payment option is for customer payment, and this schedule supplier payment is for supplier payment. First, I will explain about schedule customer payment. So click here. This is the customer payment scheduler page. From here, you need to select the date on which date you are going to schedule your payment. So select the date for tomorrow. Here you need to enter the amount. Here you need to give the description for customer payment. This one is the remind customer option. Check it here if you want to share notification with your customer regarding payment. So check it. Next, click on add button. Now you can see your customer payment has been scheduled successfully here. Now I will tell you about supplier payment. So close it from here. Click on payment schedule button. Select the schedule supplier payment option. So this is the supplier payment scheduler page. Select the service from here for what you are going to schedule the payment. Next, select the supplier. Here you need to select the date, on which date you are going to schedule the payment. So select the date for tomorrow. Here you need to enter the amount. If you want to select the text, then you can select the text from here like this. Here you need to add the narration for this transaction in this way. Next, click on the add button. Here you can see your supplier payment has been scheduled successfully. So close it from here. Now let's move to the invoice. Click on invoice, navigate to invoices. Whatever the payment you have scheduled for customer, one auto invoice has been generated and saved in draft section of your invoice list. Now you can see here whatever the amount you have scheduled through schedule customer payment, it automatically moved to your draft section. Now you can see here this edit button is used to share invoice with your customer. So click here. Here you need to enter the title and here you need to give the description. Give the description here like this. Now select the text if you want. Select GST. Next, click on the create PDF for your invoice. So click here. Now you can see your PDF has been generated. Now click on this preview option to preview your invoice PDF. So your invoice PDF will be generated like this. You can see this is your invoice PDF. Now come back. Now you need to send this invoice. So click on send button and select the create and send option. Now your invoice has been shared with your customer. So if you get the payment from this customer, so check this and mark it as he paid. Now you can see your invoice status has been updated. Once you get the payment from customer, you can shift from draft section to paid section. Now by mistake, if you shifted any invoice to paid, then you can again change it by click on this unpaid option. Next, let us move to the supplier payment section for whatever the entire amount you want to release to your supplier. You can see here, this is the supplier payment list. You can directly release the payment from here. You can see this release payment button. So click here. You can see here, it is showing amount, whatever the amount you have received from your customer. Now this is the release payment section. Enter the invoice, PO and the voucher number, whatever you get from your invoice. Next, this is the ITC, that is input text created. It will tell you whatever the text you have released to your supplier. So check it on ITC. Now upload the documents, whatever you want against this transaction. Next, click on submit button. Now your payment has been released to your supplier. Let us prepare the trial balance now for this booking. So again, move to the booking. Click on leads, navigate to bookings. Next, click on the booking follow-up button. You can see here this complete calculation button, which is used to prepare the trial balance. So click here. Now you can see here your debit and credit total amount. If there is any additional credential you can release, then add here the credit amount like 5,000. You need to give the description, like narration will be ground expense, so enter the narration here. Next, click on add button to add your extra credential. Now your additional details have been saved successfully. Now click on save button. This pop-up message, are you sure to convert this query to complete it? So click OK. So once you converted your particular booking into completed, that will be appear in the complete list. So navigate to completed. You can see this is the entire completed lead list. So you can see here, this is the follow-up button. Click on this. This is the complete lead follow-up page, you can see. Now move to the timeline section. In timeline section, your entire transaction will be appear here. You can see from the beginning, your lead has been generated. Now quotation has been sent. Stage updated successfully to booking. You can see everything. Your invoice has been created with invoice number. You can see here your customer payment has been scheduled on the particular date. In timeline section, you will get the entire information. So you can see your invoice status has been changed now. Your additional income is this for the ground expense. You can get also the profit report from here. You can see total expenses this 70,000, total income is this, so your profit is 10,000. So it was all about the booking. You can see here your stage is updated successfully into the completed. Now your booking is completed. So it was all about booking in TraviYo. Thank you.